King Louis XIV was born on September 5th, 1638, in Saint-Germain-en-Laye, France, to King Louis XIII and Queen Anne of Austria. They had been married for 23 years before his birth, and thus he was considered a miracle baby. His name literally means gift of God.
His father died in 1643, and he inherited the throne when he was only 4 years old. His mother and chief minister, Cardinal Jules Mazarin, ruled on his behalf until he became of age, increasing the nobles' power. This caused a civil war in 1648 and instilled a lifelong fear of rebellion in Louis XIV as he became active king at age 12.
After taking over as king, he diminished the position of chief minister, claiming that he was the direct representation of God and had divine right to the throne.
King Louis XIV worked to centralize and stabilize the power of the French monarchy during his 72-year reign. He diminished the power of the nobility, who had been encouraging civil war amongst the lower class, known as the Fronde. In order to protect himself from civil unrest and to establish his absolute rule, King Louis relocated the government 10 miles outside of Paris to Versailles and built the Palace of Versailles, a Baroque representation of his unlimited power. He is still known for his infamous saying, "L'État c'est moi," or "I am the state."
He also established the Code Louis, which was the first nationally unifying French law. Under this, maritime, commercial, and criminal laws were established, and it was the first time that marriages, baptisms, and deaths were noted beyond the church. This code was considered one of the most influential documents in French history and was the basis for the Napoleonic Code.
He also cemented Catholicism as the national religion, diminishing any other religions within the state, especially Protestantism. He ordered the destruction of any Protestant schools and churches. His famous motto was, "One King, One Law, One Faith."
King Louis XIV was more interested in the development of arts and culture than that of politics. He sought to be immortalized within French paintings and even created the color royal blue in honor of his power.
At this time, he began to learn dance under the direction of Pierre Beauchamp.
Pierre Beauchamp was the official ballet master of King Louis XIV. He is most notable for establishing danse des cols, the method for technique in ballet, and even created the five positions of the feet that we still use to this day.
Under this direction, he still could not perform entrechat and therefore invented a step known as the royale that only he was allowed to perform. He instilled court dancing as a requirement for noble life and would even behead people for not properly executing steps.
He would also put on major performances for the nobility. A major political work he performed in was Ballet de la Nuit, where he performed as Apollo and earned the nickname as the Sun King. He performed in this piece when he was only 15 years old, but it cemented the status for the ruler of France.
This was a political representation of how King Louis pacified the rebellion within France. He increased and protected the power of the monarchy. Under his rule, France became one of the most dominant powers in Europe, and he was the longest reigning king in France.
King Louis XIV would perform as the lead in ballet de cour, or ballet of the courts, until his retirement in 1653.
Even after his retirement from performing, King Louis XIV furthered the advancement of ballet by taking it from court life into performance. He opened two schools, the Royal Academy of Dance in 1661 and the Royal Academy of Dance and Music in 1672. However, the Royal Academy of Dance and Music didn't receive any government funding until after the French Revolution, when it was finally granted a complete monopoly in France.
King Louis XIV would soon make Jean-Baptiste Lully, an Italian composer, the director of the Académie d'Opéra. Between Lully and Beauchamp, ballet was advanced to performance and technical vocabulary, thus establishing a cultural prominence within France and across Europe. The Royal Academy of Dance and Music transcended expectations under the direction of Pierre Beauchamp, raising the standards of technique and performance, and even allowing women to study and learn under Dance de Cour. Notable women of the Baroque era included Marie Camargo and Marie Salet.
Camargo was known for her impeccable technique, which surpassed the men of her era. Salet, on the other hand, was known for her incredible expression. The two were always in rivalry, and it even sparked debates and even riots about who was the better dancer.
The Royal Academy of Dance and Music still continues to thrive as the Paris Opera today.
King Louis XIV died in 1715, right before his 77th birthday, of gangrene.
Despite being a rather controversial political ruler in France's history, King Louis XIV is most widely recognized as a great patron of the arts, particularly through his formation of the Royal Academy of Dance and Music. For the first time, dance was being performed on stage and was considered a recognized professional art form through government support. His contributions allowed for the spark of Romantic ballet period, which is considered the height of balletic growth in France. He also established the Code Louis, which was the first nationally unifying French law. Oh my gosh.
Wait for that.
You're like facing the camera and you do the face.
Hold on, I gotta get it going.
That was amazing.
Wait.
Glad he was there.